This is obviously a great day for Drs. Karikó and Dr. Weissman. It is also a great day for science.
The Nobel Assembly at Karolinska Institutet has today decided to award the 2023 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine jointly to Katalin Karikó and Drew Weissman for their discoveries concerning nucleoside base modifications that enabled the development of effective mRNA vaccines against COVID-19.
I get the first call, although they tried to reach Drew, but somehow their telephone number did not work. So they called me up. It was 3:40 or something, very early, and my husband picked up the phone and talked to somebody and said, you know, this is for you. So he handed over the telephone and, you know, was said that, you know, me and Drew Weissman will receive the Nobel Prize today. And I was like, I didn't know whether it is real, you know. We suspected maybe some, you know, prank. Yeah.
And we said, you know, this has to be a prank. Some anti-vaxxer is, you know, playing with us and, you know, this can't be real. But, you know, we sit back and we wait for the announcement, and we sat in bed and, you know, looking at my wife, and my cat is begging for food. And we wait and the press conference starts, and it was real. So then we really became excited by this.
Drew came from NIH, and I was already here in 1997, already 8 years, and working with doing messenger RNA things. And I brag about that I can do RNA, and Drew was interested in vaccines, and that's how our collaboration started.
We worked side by side all of that time because we couldn't get funding, we couldn't get publications, we couldn't get really people to notice RNA as something interesting. It had failed clinical trials, and pretty much everybody gave up on it. Katie lit the match, and we spent the rest of, I don't know, 20 plus years working together, figuring out how to get it to work, how to get a vaccine to function well. And COVID hit, and the vaccines were recognized for 95% efficacy, which was really a turning point in RNA therapeutics. We would sit together in 1997 and afterwards and talk about all of the things that we thought RNA could do. All of the vaccines and therapeutics and gene therapies, and just realizing how important it had the potential to be. And that's why we never gave up, and we just kept persevering and kept working at it, and here we are today. Since COVID and all the attention, we've been able to tell the world about what we're doing. But we've got clinical trials for 7 vaccines going on right now. We've got work on cancer vaccines, vaccines for autoimmune diseases, for allergies. We've got gene therapy moving into clinical development. We've got a variety of therapeutics. So, you know, it's already been going on for many years, and this has just given RNA the recognition.